In this video, I want to show you how to use SaasAnt to bulk delete things out of your QuickBooks. This is my demo QuickBooks where I put a bunch of information in here and I make a huge mess out of it, and then periodically I just need to give it a reset. I'm going to do a little bit of a reset, and I realized maybe you'd like to see how that happens. Maybe you have a QuickBooks file that you use for sample work, but then it's gotten cluttered and you want to delete stuff and you want to just refresh. So let me show you how to do that. I already have SaasAnt connected, and so I'm going to go to Apps and then Overview. I'm going to go to SaasAnt and I'm going to click Launch. In my earlier videos, I've been using Import, but in this case, I wanted to use Delete. Like that's my big goal. I want to delete stuff. So I'll say Initiate Cleanup. Here's your steps. I'm like, yep, I'm ready to clean up. Delete by searching, delete by reference. I think we're going to do searching. I'm like, there's so many reference numbers. And then my transaction list, what do I want to delete? Well, a lot. Let's start by deleting some expenses. And then by transaction date, create date, upload date, let's do transaction date. I think I have stuff in here going back maybe 10 years. Not that I was doing this 10 years ago, but rather I entered stuff myself and I just randomly picked a date 10 years ago. So let's try that and then have it end. Can I end here? Search. So I'm deleting expenses by the transaction date. My big goal is just to clean it all up. I can't mess it up because it's my sample file. If you were doing this, you would be much more methodical about what you're going to delete. If you're a small business owner and you have the bright idea to delete stuff, please don't. Please take a very long moment to think about the consequences of doing a big delete. But if you're in a situation where it's appropriate and you know that it's appropriate, you know you're not going to mess anything up, go for it. This does not feel like enough. I know that today alone, I have added more than three things. But let's delete. And then we'll figure out something else we can do. Okay, it says three things have been deleted. I guess I'm going to say show results, even though I don't really care. I feel that I have more than three things. So let me go to expenses. And yeah, there's definitely more. So let's go back and let's try it again. Let's go to delete. Ready to clean up. Delete by searching. Maybe I got mad that I was trying to delete so much stuff. So I'm choosing the date range January 2024 through February 1st, 2025, expenses by transaction date, and then I'll search. All right, so this was good. It shows me 28 records. I'm going to go ahead and choose delete. Okay, so it says that 10 things were deleted and 5 things failed. Let me look at the failed. So I have, it says checking account 1234 parentheses deleted. That means that I've inactivated the checking account and it can't do this. This it can't delete because it's matched to another transaction. So not foolproof, but not bad. So up here it says deleted data will be available for download for 2 days. I could download it. I'm not going to. For me to clean up my QuickBooks and really delete all of the entries, I'm going to have to fiddle around a bit more with SaasAnt to see what it is that I'm doing and why I'm only able to delete a handful of things. Let me just go back to this and we'll see what's left. And then we'll call this video done. So my transactions, I want to look at expense type. Oh, that's not bad. Oh no, let me look at the filter. So 1124 through 2125. This is the date range I picked. So there are these, and it did say that there was, there are 5 here, and were there 5 failed? Oh no, I'd have to go back and look at the video. So not foolproof, but definitely functional. I don't want to create too many SaasAnt videos because I really want to focus on QuickBooks. But I also wanted to show you a tool that I use just in case it inspires you to learn more about the tool or in case what I'm doing might be helpful for you in some way. All right, thanks.